tutorial consists of three main steps. First, the star itself and some procedural notes for its material. Second, some force fields. This is the most important part. These force fields will drive some smoke domains to give us the illusion of the solar atmosphere and some eruptions, flares, reaching towards the outer space. And finally, some texturing tricks to make the effect, the illusion, look more convincing. So let's start with the star itself. As you see, the star is just basically a default UV sphere. If I turn off the visibility of everything else, we can have a look at it. Alright, every value is at default, and I set the shading to smooth. And as for the material, it cannot be more simple. I have two noise textures. Here we can see the whole setup. I have two noise textures, one for the large scale details and one for the high frequency details. And they are mixed together by a color mix RGB node, and I set the blend mode to color burn. That looks the most convincing. And in the end, I chose two colors set up in a color ramp, an orange for the calm and bright yellow for the more hot, more fast moving areas. And I'm driving two emission shaders so I can set up their strength independently. I set the strength of the bright areas to 2, so they are a bit more distinct, and I combine them with a mix shader. And the factor for this mix shader is a color ramp for a bit more contrast, and this color ramp is defined by our two noise textures here. And that's about it. If I now go to rendered view, you can see it for yourself. And as for animation, I just simply set the distortion of these textures here from 0 to 1. And also here, the distortion starts at 0.2 and ends at 0.5. So basically that's about it. And I animated the rotation, the Z rotation of the UV sphere itself from 0 to 60. With all this done, we can concentrate on the main topic of this tutorial, the solar atmosphere itself. The corona is basically a smoke domain driven by a force field. The simplest setup you can think of. Let's start with the force field. Here you can see I have set up these force fields in separate collections. This will be very important later on. For the main corona effect, I used a turbulence force field, and here you can have a look at the settings. The strength must be higher than the default. I set it to 10, and the size, the scale of the force field should be fairly low. So you can see the curliness and waviness close to the surface of the sun. And also the flow setting is really important. That will give you a more restricted look. If you set up a particle system, it will help you to visualize the effect of these force fields. And I set the noise amount to 3, so it gives a bit more random motion. So this was for the force field. And then I jump to the smoke domain itself. So if I open it, you see it consists of two objects, an emitter and a smoke. So let's turn them on. If I turn this on, and you can see, here we have our atmosphere in its full glory. And it looks quite alright. To achieve this, let's go back to object mode. To achieve this effect here, you need to set up first the corona flow object. This is basically the same default UV sphere. I just simply duplicated it from the original sun body object. And then I set the smoke simulation type to flow. I set the surface distance to 2 meters. I didn't want it to reach too far away. And basically that's it, everything is at default otherwise. And then the corona smoke domain. This is our domain type smoke simulation object, and I set a dissolve value to 150 frames because we obviously don't want this solar atmosphere to grow forever. I turned on adaptive domain to spare some memory, and I baked it to an external location because it's always safer. I turned off gravity, and as for the effector collection, I chose the one which contains our corona turbulence force field. And one more step. Under the collections tab, we have to set the flow to the corona smoke collection, which contains our emitter or flow object. And that's it. I baked it, and here we see the final smoke simulation. If I jump through the timeline, you can see it growing and moving just as we wanted. Alright, and for the shading, I have here a really simple node setup. If we quickly gloss over it, you see that the core of it is a principal volume shader. The same orange color is set up here as for the sun body object. And it is mixed with a transparent BSDF, so you will have empty and smoke filled patches of the space, and this separation is driven by the density of the smoke simulation itself by an attribute node and some contrast fine tuning and some additional noise which gave a finer illusion of motion. And when we have a look at it, we have achieved our goal. Obviously, it would be nice to have some halo effect around the body of our sun. And for that, I used a very simple smoke simulation without any complications. So this smoke simulation is a very simple one. I will turn it on now. As you see, it is a simple sphere of smoke. And the settings are the... as you see, it is a simple smoke sphere with adaptive domain turned on, all the field weights turned off, and the flow collection is set to the halo emitter collection, which is basically another duplication of our sun's body. And I baked only 2 frames. That was far enough from the surface. And as for the shading, this material is exactly the same as for our corona object, with one exception. I added a layer weight node here and set the blend to fairly low to eliminate this effect, the halo, from the middle of our view, so it doesn't interfere with the body of the sun itself. And the final step was the eruption smoke domain. If I turn it on, you won't see any major difference here. It is only to give a more rich illusion of motion. Okay, now I turned off the visibility of every other smoke domain. You can have a peek at it. And its material is the same, again, as our corona smoke. I have changed the contrast of the density texture, and also I changed the contrast of the secondary noise. I animated the noise texture values here, as I did with the corona smoke domain, so the plasma waves in a more convincing way. To see these animation values, if you are curious, in the beginning they are 5, 6 and 5, respectively for scale, detail and distortion, and at the end I go to 3, 2 and 2, and for the most important settings, the volumetrics, you need to set the tile size to 2 pixels, that's the highest resolution possible, and the samples to 256 with a distribution of 1. And then you can hit render and hope for the best. Thanks for watching, I hope that you found it useful and see you next time.